Okay, so Apple have updated their Reminders app. So how do we get it working on our iOS devices? Hello and welcome to this second episode of my Working with Reminders series. My name is Carl Pullein, and in this week's episode, I'm going to show you how Apple Reminders works on the iOS device. Now, I'm going to show you using an iPad, but for all intents and purposes, the iPad and the iPhone work pretty much the same way. Now, as I was preparing this video and as I was researching Reminders app, I realized that what Apple have actually done is they've created an application, their Reminders app, they've built it from the ground up, really for iOS, because it looks and works so much better on iOS. And if you watched the first episode earlier this week, you would have seen there are a few glitches in the macOS Catalina version, but in the iOS version, I didn't find any of those glitches. Anyway, let me take you into the iOS version on my iPad and show you how it all works from the iPad. And you'll see what I mean about how it just looks so much better on the iPad. Now, before I go any further, if you do get any value from this episode, then I would be most grateful if you would hit that like button. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet and you want to get all the latest news, tips and tricks on productivity, time management and goal planning, then please hit that subscribe button. Okay, let me take you into Mac iOS Reminders and show you what I mean. Okay, so here we are in my winter holiday. So if you haven't actually watched episode one of this series, then maybe you want to just quickly jump over there and have a look, because then you'll see how I've set up the basic system. So essentially, just a quick overview. I have my routines folders in there. So those of you who've done the Your Digital Life 2.0 online course or read the book, you know all about the routines. You've got a daily, a weekly, and a monthly routine. Then we've got the work folder. There's nothing in there at the moment. And the personal folder, or group as Reminders likes to call them, and I've got in there my winter holiday. Now, one of the beauties of this is, as you can see with the way this is set up, I added the message in terms of like Langyong, which is my wife's name. I added that in as remind me when I contact this person. So whether if I'm using messages, which I do all the time, this will remind me to ask her where she would like to go this winter. I've added the note in there. So if I just tap on the side of there, you've got the information bar. And on the iOS devices, and I get the feeling that Reminders has been essentially made for iOS. It's okay on the laptop. It works fine. You can add all the details in, but it actually looks so much better. And you have so many more options when you use an iOS device. So here I'm using the dark mode on the iPad. And I should point out that this is exactly how it functions on the iPhone as well. So I have the questions here, right here on my in the details of the note. I can set a reminder, so I can tap that and it will give me remind me, and let's say I need to click on there, so October the 9th, which is Wednesday, it can remind me on a day, so it's going to be done. So I've added that, and that's now come up for today. And as you can see now, I have that set up. It comes up in my today list. Now I've got one here. Let's go into this one. This is a brand new one. Let's hit the I button. Look into the best friend. I don't really need to look at that. So remind me on a day. Remind me today. Again, I can just check that. So that's done. I'm not going to repeat it. So you can actually create repeating tasks. This is great for your routines. I can actually remind me at a location. So I can do this at my home. So I can just tap on there. It's not going to let me do that. All right, let's do current location. Sorry, while using app. There we go. So I can do that. And that's been done. So it can remind me when I'm at home. I've done that. And it'll come up arriving Carl Pullein's home. So when I'm arriving. Now I can click on that and go back on the information. I want it when I'm leaving. So remind me at a time. So leaving. So tap that. And details done. So now it's changing. See, leaving when I leave my home. So there's a nice feature that that the reminders function gives us, I can now add in here book flights for winter hotel, for the winter holiday. Now again, in this situation, I may have a URL that I can add in there. So let's just go into Safari. And so we're going to go into Safari, and we go KLM. So I'm just going to take that site. I'm going to copy the site. So copy, let's move back to, and I'm going to add the URL in there. So I can just paste the URL, done. And you can now see that Google has come. So I can just tap on that now and it will take me to the KLM. So let's just get the actual KLM website. So there we go. I'm going to copy that. Copy, go back to my information, tap on that. Let's just get rid of this. And I'll give you the correct location. What I really want to do is to show you the kind of information that you're getting. And you're going to get this on your phone as well, by the way. So you tap on there, paste, I can hit return. And that's going to come up on there. Remind me on a day, blah, 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 blah. I'm going to flag this. And I'm going to remind me to do that tomorrow. So let's go November 10th and done. And so now what you'll see is that's come up as a flag on there. It didn't come up on a flag. Let's go back in here. Let's change this. I see what's happened here. For some reason, the flagging is not coming up. You have to turn the flagging on. So when I tap done, it's now going to show me the two flagged ones. So when I tap on there, it's giving me the messaging and it's giving me the website to go to the holidays. So these are just some of the things that you can do, and it's a really, really effective. Now, when you use this on your phone, it looks absolutely amazing. Now I can go into my today view, and I've got my flags in there. So these are the things that I want to do, and they will all come up. When I'm messaging my wife, it'll ask reminders, so it's going to remind me to do it. So this, for a simple, easy to use to-do list manager, this is such a fantastic tool to use. And you get so much value out of it, and it's completely free. So if you just spend a little bit of time playing around with this app, you're going to find that this could replace some of the to-do list managers that you may be using at the moment. And if you're in the Apple ecosystem, there are some really, really cool things that you can do that you might want to find. And I'm going to show you those in the next episode. So join me in the next episode, coming out hopefully on Thursday this week. So it just remains for me now to wish you all a very, very productive week. Thank you for watching this video. Now, if you want to take your productivity to a higher level, then get yourself enrolled in my 2019 edition of Your Digital Life 2.0 online. It is a complete, comprehensive productivity and time management course, and it's a course that will take you to levels of productivity you have only ever dreamt of before. It shows you how to build your very own COD system, collect, organize, and do. It shows you how to create the folder structure, how to build into your goals, into your daily to-do list. It has everything. And not only that, you will get a free copy of Your Digital Life 2.0, the book. You also get a free workbook, and you get access to all the slides that are used in the course. It is incredible value. I want to see you in that course. If you are serious about becoming productivity, then please join me in Your Digital Life 2.0, the 2019 edition. Thank you very much for watching this video.